Yellow rattle, like all broom rapes, is a parasite. These have green chlorophyll, they photosynthesize, so they're a hemiparasite, a partial parasite. And they have specialized roots called hosteria, which attach the xylem of the yellow rattle, and the xylem is the plumbing system, to the xylem of the host, so they can then suck up water and nutrients from the host to the plant. Plants exchange air through pores called stomata, and they shut off their stomata at night in order to preserve water. Hemiparasites keep them open, and in doing so, they lose water, they dry out, and so they suck up more water from the host into the plant, bringing water and nutrient with it. So because of this lack of nutrient and this reduction sometimes in water, the host plants do less well. Chris Gibson, in his PhD, showed that yellow rattle has been recorded attacking 50 different species of plant from 18 different families. And he showed that the consequence of yellow rattle was complicated. If they preferentially select the dominant species, then the subdominance increase and diversity increases. If they ignore the dominant species, then diversity decreases. In practice, they usually go for the dominant species, very often dominant grasses, and so usually yellow rattle increases diversity. This process is probably a general one. If parasites or herbivores or land managers preferentially hit the dominant species, diversity will increase. If they preferentially impact the rarer species, diversity will decrease. So understanding selectivity is key to understanding the impact of these factors.